seems to become at night. The wet streets glistening under the glare of lamps are deserted and lonely, and the river sleeps. Even when the moon breaks through, it doesn't disturb the stillness of the shadows. But sometimes, in the darkness, terrible things happen, like murder. Then maybe you read about it in the morning paper. Perhaps the murder is a front page headline, or perhaps it's just a paragraph tucked away among the snippets. But as you go to your work, you may think about it. And sometimes you may wonder if ever you'll be the unfortunate who stumbles on someone in the night. Someone who's so desperate that your life means nothing to him. Yes, every morning you go to work, and then one day you will be missing. All the others will be there, but you will be missing. Oh yes, you thought of yourself. But have you ever given a grain of sympathy to the murderer? Oh no, I'm not going to make a plea for the criminal. I know. He's a human being too. I know what it feels like to be hunted. There's no rest and there's no peace for the murderer. In your home, you feel trapped. And when you get outside, it isn't any easier, although you try to tie yourself into forgetfulness by walking and walking and walking. Yet you can't walk fast enough to escape from something you're carrying around inside you, your fear. And if anyone speaks to you, your heart begins to race. Yes, you run and you run. And then perhaps you think you'll take a train somewhere. Anywhere, just to get the hell out of it. And then you remember that the stations are the first places the police watch. And you haven't got the nerve. Yet you don't know what you can do to save yourself. Of course, you know that a city is full of millions of people, and that it ought to be easy to hide among them. But all the time, you wonder how much the millions know about you. Have they got posters outside the police stations with details about you? They don't go and look. But perhaps all the others know. What chance have you got against millions of spies? You get suspicious of everyone. And when you're not on the move, you feel you're in danger. Thing is a vicious circle, that you're making yourself conspicuous. But there's nothing you can do about it. And there comes a time when you can't even summon up the courage to go back home. You feel that someone may be waiting for you there, and so you have to roam and prowl and dodge by night as well as by day. There are moments when you long just for an end. You're tired of being a hunted beast, but it isn't always so easy in a big city. And as the days pass, you take on the outward appearance of your inner guilt. No, damn you, you can't tell me anything about it. I know what one has to do. In the end, one has to give oneself up. Just to find some peace. Yes, I've confessed to hundreds of murders. The police just laugh when I come to them. They say I'm crazy, a man who just imagines things. They say there are lots of people like me who make a confession every time they read about a murder, and they tend to have me shut up in a home if I confess again. But I wonder what would happen if I ever did commit a murder. Would they go on refusing to believe me? You see, one night, and then maybe you'll read about it in the morning paper. And perhaps after what I've told you, it'll be your turn to be a little more imaginative. Perhaps it'll be your turn to think yourself into the murderer's shoes. And all the time it'll be me who's done it. That's funny, isn't it? But I'll be sorry for you. You'll have hell.